and the Xbox One. This video we'll be talking about multiple things. First of all, as you guys have noticed on my Twitter page, if you guys haven't followed me yet, please go follow. I have recently acquired a new logo for my rebranding. The logo is from Ascend. I will be leaving a link for his Twitter below so you guys can check him out. He has some sick logo designs as well as banner designs. If you guys are interested, he's very cheap and his quality is top notch. So you guys will be seeing the new logo on my thumbnail as well as my Twitter account, my YouTube account, the little watermark on the bottom right of my videos. So that will be my new rebranding of my logos from now on, and I want to give him a quick shout out for that, you know, nice and clean logo, because I've been looking for one ever since, you know, I really wanted to do my own rebranding, and it's just been hard. The other thing we'll be talking about is I will be getting back into dancing. I will be getting back into breakdancing, hip-hopping, trying to at least. I started around like junior year of high school, and then as soon as I got out of high school, I graduated high school, I stopped because there was just too many things in my head. I had college to attend to, I had multiple jobs, and I started playing video games, and I couldn't time manage correctly. So I'm hoping that this year I will have the time to be able to time manage better with my gaming, my YouTube career, my school, and my dancing. And yeah, I'm hoping that I can time manage that very well, as well as with my multiple with my jobs that I'm going to be trying to get over the summer. The other thing that I will be trying to do is playing flag football in Minnesota. I'm going to be trying to be working out hard and long for the next 2 months so I can get into shape to play football, flag football for my uncles and my friends' team. I'm going to be exercising with them every Sunday. I'm hoping that, you know, my hopes are not going to be to be able to join the team, because I know I've been playing with them for multiple years. Practicing with them for multiple years, and things have come up, so I'm not gonna put my hopes up. But if they really want me on the team, and if I will practice with them, you know, we'll see what happens in the long run. But that's what I'll be doing as well. And the last thing we will the next thing we'll be talking about is being yourself on YouTube. A lot of YouTubers think that you have to talk about today's trend or anything that's really catchy in order to catch, you know, people's attention to view your channel, to subscribe to your channel, to comment on it. But in my opinion, I think you need to be yourself. You don't need to impress others, or you don't need to do like super stuff or like multiple challenges or anything just to gauge people's attention. I just think that if you are, you know, true to your YouTube channel and you produce good content, then you should be fine on your YouTube channel. You know, you don't have to act stupid or act foolish or, you know, trash talk yourself or other people in a way that gauges your attention. I just feel that you just have to be yourself and believe in yourself and what you're doing to your YouTube channel and the content that you produce. If you think it's good, then you should feel 100% confident about it. You know, don't let all that negativity about people, you know, telling you what to do, how to do it, you know, influence your how you make the videos, because every person's video is unique regarding, you know, how you record it, when you record it. You know, somebody could have in my opinion, I think someone who has a lower quality video but have a good commentary and vlog will beat anybody who has a 720p quality video and has a poor commentary slash kind of gameplay type of deal. So I'm just, you know, in the mindset of like, you know, don't be afraid to, you know, express yourself, to be yourself. I know in today's society it's just a little hard because there's cyberbullying, there's bullying, there's, you know, people make fun of one another, but and honesty, if you, you know, just be 100% yourself and show the world and show, or show the YouTube community that, you know, you're confident on what you produce, you know, you'll be successful. Other than that, I think that's gonna end the video here, guys. Oh, and the last thing we'll be talking about is that throughout this whole video, as you guys have, noticed, I will be using the MR6, which is the greatest pistol in the pistol class. I believe I got a 28 and 11 with it. It's not great numbers, but I'm only using a pistol. I believe I got the last kill with the pistol, so I'm very excited. The match was very, very close. We were up by like 8-9 kills, and then at the end, I don't know what happened to my teammates, but they all suddenly just started dying left and right. It was major annoying. So then I clutched up at the end, got the final kill with the pistol, very excited. I hope you guys enjoyed this content, guys. If you guys did, please leave a like on my video, a comment on this video on what you guys think I could do better. What do you guys agree with my points about, you know, being yourself? I'm getting back into dancing. If you guys, you know, love breakdancing or hip hopping, you know, let me know in the comments below as well. I also will be continuing my Shadow series, my Shadow Tuesday series number 5 next week. So if you guys are interested, please leave your link below. There's no requirements. Just leave your link below. I'll give your channel a full thorough look through. And I will be shouting you guys out on the next video. But otherwise, I hope you guys, like I said, I hope you guys enjoy this channel. Oh, not this channel, but this gameplay. If you guys did, you know, you guys know the drill already. Subscribe, comment, like, and we'll see you guys in the next video. And YouTube, peace.
That's a 6-6 and a kick for that SOB. Advised, hostile HCXD spotted. Objectives met. Prep for evac.
You'll always need good boots on the ground.
Talking about the next Call of Duty. I'm hoping that the next Call of Duty will be like kind of like going back to the original roots, back to Modern Warfare and Modern Warfare 2. Those are my two favorite Call of Duty games. If I had to choose between one of them, I believe Modern Warfare 2 was the better of the two before all the mods and everything came. I enjoyed Modern Warfare 2. I thought Modern Warfare 2 was probably the best Call of Duty game. I know a lot of you guys may disagree. A lot of you guys may say that Call of Duty, their very first Call of Duty was, or Call of Duty 4 was the best Call of Duty multiplayer out there. But I would have to rank that number 2 on my list. I really enjoyed Modern Warfare 2. I mean, there's no thrash on Modern Warfare, but I just thought Modern Warfare 2 was better. Modern Warfare 3 was